Mad Ruth here, avid reader, writer, painter, video gamer, movies, novels, and comic book fan. And I'm on, I think, what, fifth attempt at making this video. Last night, you know, feeling pretty good, feeling pretty buzzed. Thought I would attempt to throw this video in the middle of the night, and it turned into an episode all into itself. Basically, with each take, I took a shot of my Jager, and by take number four, I was pretty much an incoherent blabble and mess. But anyways, I saw the video this morning and I realized I forgot to turn the music down through the video, so all you could hear was background music just drowning out the video. So here's my fifth attempt, hoping I can somewhat get this one right in a sober state of mind. Put something up for October, and anyone who caught that video last night, when I woke up this morning I took it down. But any case, I decided I'd do a video today because a few things have happened in October. So my Soltac update for this month, Gonzalo's now officially on page 44 of Soltac, which is awesome. That means we're halfway through the storyboard. And I'm on page 53. So, yeah. So 88 pages of that. And if you weren't aware, like, what does this guy do for his comic book? I write all these. This is what I do every night. I sit here and I storyboard. Yeah. Like I said, that's 52 and I'm on 53. So 88 pages of storyboard for each book, hoping to release volume 1, volume 2, volume 3. That would be awesome. That would fulfill my expectations. Fulfilling a wish of mine. But in any case, so also as well, if it's your first time on my channel, that's like the half issue. That's the prototype that I made for copyright. So with everyone who backs my campaign, man, why am I so dyslexic? Everyone who backs my campaign will get a copy of this half issue. I've actually updated this. I've updated this half issue with a version 4 at this point, which looks drastically different from this one. But I'm quite proud of that. I created that, edited it, pre-press. I did everything I could with that one. But the actual graphic novel, all the pre-press will be taken care of for me. In addition, some other stretch goal stuff you can get with the campaign. That's a die-cut sticker. It'll be trimmed up, and probably I'll go with something shiny, a lot nicer with the actual one. A couple examples of prototype stickers. And some examples of the trading cards that I made for the campaign, right? So there are quite a few add-ons that I'm throwing in there. Every backer, like I said, will get the 0.5 issue and the graphic novel. That's sort of my way for making up for international shipping. I mean, you get a half issue, which is 16 pages, the graphic novel, 48 pages, stickers, trading cards, and all that will be $25 plus shipping. Which, hey, that's a lot cheaper than a lot of the other campaigns if you stop and think about it. But, more stickers and hard case tripping cards. Like I said, I wanted to do an update with you for October. So a couple big things happened for this month. So me and Gonzalo, around the middle of Fragtober, I don't know if you're watching this channel, if you watch Fragtober as well. Gonzalo is the artist working on Soltac, Gonzalo Loyola, and myself. Like, we've been working on this book nonstop since pretty much December of 2020. And I sort of mentioned to him, I said, hey, you wanna try and do a Black Flag piece? And, Gonzalo's watching professionals and he's watching Fragtober, but he was obviously concerned because he wasn't familiar with the characters. And I told him I'd send him something and I did up a little drawing. I gave him references for all five characters for Geisha and Rascal, Sniper, Gorilla, and Raiden. So basically with minor consultation, I talked him through the piece, and he created this absolutely beautiful piece of line art, which we presented as a gift to Dan Fraga, and basically asked him if he wanted the drawing, and I asked him for some guidance and direction, and he basically told me to put it out on social media and see if people like it, and ask people if they want it in the 0.5 issue. So this is the line art created by Gonzalo Loyola. And then this here is the colored version of the same piece. And again, he created this in a week. He illustrated it, did some tweaking, and fully colored it in 1 week. And this was the final product. So we threw it out on social media. We threw it on Instagram, on Twitter, on Facebook, and obviously here on YouTube as well. And we asked people if they wanted to see it in the 0.5 and asked them to like and share. And Comicsgate community came through. I don't remember the numbers exactly, but somewhere between 50 to 70 people on both of my shared Twitter accounts, another 40 or 50 people on YouTube, and then I think 30 people on Instagram all liked it and shared it. And like I said, almost 200 people shared this piece and was involved with that. And then Dan saw that, and then he said that this piece will find its way into Black Flag 0.5, which both myself and Gonzalo and I are over the moon. We're floored. That's just incredible. To go from a piece that we just sort of, hey, you want to make a piece, you want to take a break, to all of a sudden now it's going to wind up in Black Flag 0.5. So needless to say, I backed Black Flag Pineapple Perception for a second time, just to make sure that I could mail the graphic novel and the 0.5 down to Gonzalo, along with a copy of our book when our book gets completed. So I figured I'd throw that story in for October. That's pretty exciting. And then while I've got you here, I'll show you some pages out of Soltac, just to give you a good idea on what it is that me and Gonzalo are doing with our graphic novel. So Soltac's obviously, it's like a science fiction book. I'm really hesitant to give away elements because, let's be honest, the more you show of your stories and your artwork before you launch your campaign, the more likely those elements are to be absorbed by other people. So long story short, this is a scientific sci-fi adventure, sort of sci-fi opera. It takes place in the future. And this is what page 3 was. And so just saying, this is page 3. We're fully color right now up to page 32, and the line art's completed up to page 44. So this here, actually page 7, which will be in the book, it's also in the half issue. This is the very first image for the book that was created back in December, when I was first talking with Gonzalo and telling him how much I really loved his art. I mean, I found his portfolio. I must have went through 300 other artists when I narrowed down to Gonzalo. So I showed him the trading cards and the stuff out of the half issue, and this was the first piece that he made. And then pretty much from there, we've been working after this piece nonstop ever since December. This is page 8 out of the book. So as you can see, right, I threw in a full page splash. That'll be page 7. And then, bam, it jumps into page 8. And then there's Dexter Barrow in action, right? And then page 30. So there's page 30 of the book. Again, he's suited up. Obviously, he's in outer space there. You see Saturn in the background, getting all geared up. You know, the whole the montage of getting your gear ready. And then away he goes. So that's page 30. So I thought it'd be fun on this update to show you the progress that Gonzalo and I are making through the book. And then the main reason to have you here today, I figured, you know, I keep saying Mad Ruth, avid reader, writer, painter, video gamer, movies, novels, and comic book fan. So I haven't really played any modern video games past Battlefield 2. I think that's the last video game I really care about, Battlefield 2 and SOTOR. But I keep saying painter. I realized I went through what canvases I have. I haven't done a painting in 10 years. That's how long it's been since I painted. But I went through my house. I found five of my canvases, so I decided I would share my canvases with you. I figured that's a good video. So this one here is a canvas I did 18 October 2015. Sorry, 2005, 16 years ago. And then, again, I paint in acrylic back in 2005. Hey, like, time just melts away, right? And then, So here's a piece I did same year, 6 December 2005. I called it The Flame. Again. So obviously abstract acrylic, super easy to do, clean line work, and I don't know, it's my style, right? This here, it's a piece I did 19 June 2011. I called it Bane. The reason I called this piece Bane, it was the bane of my existence when I painted this thing. I struggled with this, just finding the right colors. I don't know how many times I swapped colors on the canvas just because I didn't like them. But yeah, so that's another painting I did 2011. I think 2011 is the last time I did any paintings. This one here, Sith, 14 May 2011. Pretty cool. Yeah, it matches the flags in the background. And then then that canvas there, Empire, I did 19 July 2011. So there you go. So whenever I read off my Mad Ruth, avid reader, writer, painter, right? Now you know what some of my artwork looks like. So I figured I had to throw something together for October. I said I would do a video, at least one video a month, up until I'm ready to launch my comic book. And then at that point, I will have to turn this up to at least streaming once a week, get myself more familiar with YouTube, start getting familiar with the video editing editing settings. I plan on creating content, you know, just silly stuff, right? Editing stuff. I have a couple ideas. I don't know if they'll be funny or lame or not, but learning and exploring YouTube. But that won't happen until, like I said, middle of June next year, when I have a bit more spare time on my hands and my campaign launches, and then we'll go from there. So I'll continue to do one video a month. I said I would do one video a month, and I've kept my word up until my campaign launches in June, and then we'll go from there. So to everyone still following my channel, still being patient, I'll try to not do drunken stone streams because I realize it doesn't really work. But I will give you a video once a month. I'm not taking a shot because, like I said, last night's fiasco was four takes, four shots, and I knocked myself out for the night, so I won't do it this time. But any case, have a good weekend. Thank you, and goodbye.